Hi, Alan. My name is Mark. Francis and I are going to present to you our research project on Part A, Usability Requirements Analysis and Feasibility Study to update a digital business product or service. And our digital product of choice is the Lewis real-time app. The Lewis is a light rail transit system which is operated by Transdev in Dublin City. It consists of two lines, the red and the green. In the latest figures released by Transdev in 2016, 34.2 million people used the Lewis services, with 90,000 daily average users. The application itself was developed by Dovetail Technologies, and now I'll pass you over to Francis, who will explain the current application in more detail.
In 2013, the Lewis app was created for the Apple iOS and Android operating systems. This application meant that anybody who had a smartphone could simply download the Lewis app and have access to all the Lewis information in a matter of seconds. This app provides the following: RTPI, which is real-time passenger information, cost of fares, maps of the Lewis red and green line, as well as any news about disruptions to the service. We've also identified two user groups. First are the main users, such as Lewis commuters, who use the trams daily. These users are familiar with the current app layout. Arrival time is critical for these users. Our second user group is those unfamiliar with the system, such as tourists. They would have a high expectation of a modern transport system. Our first research method is extreme user interviews. How do we do this? We need to identify individuals who are extremely familiar or completely unfamiliar with the product and ask them to evaluate their experience using it. According to IDEO, these individuals should be able to highlight key issues of the design problem and provide insights for the design improvement. To do this, we have 10 participants, 5 familiar and 5 unfamiliar. These interviews are an ongoing process. Our second research method is fly on the wall. How do we do this? We observe and record behavior within its context without interfering with people's activities. According to IDEO, this will be useful to see what people actually do within the real context rather than accept what they say they do. By spending time observing Lewis customers' interactions with the app and also their interactions with the Lewis ticket purchasing system, we can see their interactions, and from this we can incorporate findings and ideas into the design process. Our third research method is narration. How do we do this? As they perform a process or execute a specific task, we ask participants to describe aloud what they are thinking. According to IDEO, this is a useful way to reach users' motivations, concerns, perceptions, and reasoning. In order to understand the user's needs from the app, we can ask them to describe what they are thinking whilst using it. Take a look at the following video of one of our participants.
I'm going to choose the green line from Windy Arbor, and it's showing there's 1 June now in 8 minutes' time. And the fare is 240 single person, but it's not showing a return fare. And there's no sign for a payment.
So the video we just showed you highlights the number one requirement from users that we tested across all methods. We've decided to follow up with two more IDEO research methods to validate this requirement. The first is the look technique of time lapse. So according to IDEO, this method is useful for summarizing activity over time using time, space, and location. With mobile payment popping up as the potential requirement, we plan on using this method to monitor the current ticket booths at peak times to help us validate this as an update for the app. The next method is personal inventory from the look techniques also. So according to IDEO, this is documenting things that people identify as important to them as a way of cataloging evidence of their lifestyle. This method is useful for revealing people's activities, perceptions and values, as well as patterns among them. With this method, we plan on asking people what are the 5 most important things they carry on in their person. We feel this would further validate whether a mobile payment update to the app would be viable.